everybody, and welcome to a very special episode of Mayle And Mackert Reviews. I'm Bo Mayle, and Cameron's not with me today, because this is such a very special video that I've been really wanting to do, you know, for a while, and finally the day has come. I have seen Star Wars Episode 7. Yeah! And today I'm going to be talking about Star Wars Episode 7. This review is going to be spoiler-free. I'm not going to give anything out based on spoilers. You're going to have to see this movie for yourself. So, and if you're the unfortunate person who did see a review that has spoilers on it, so today, when I got ready and all dressed up to see the Star Wars Episode 7, I can't even tell you how ecstatic I was to see this movie. It was one of the biggest hyped up movies of all time, ever since Disney bought Star Wars, and I heard that J.J. Abrams was going to make this Star Wars flick. I was like, man, I don't know. I've seen Lost. It's a great series, but it has major flaws. And I have seen the Star Trek movies that he has done. The second one mostly has its flaws. I don't know what's going to happen until I saw the trailers. The first one is like, wow. That's what J.J. Abrams did? And then it got better with the second trailer, when the third trailer came out, I was like, okay, you got me. I'm gonna see this movie. And I bought that ticket like about a month, I believe, ago. Yeah, a month ago. And I was getting more pumped up by seeing all of these TV spots and everything else. It felt like that, man, I'm actually gonna see a Star Wars movie. Because I've seen the prequels of the movies, and they weren't that any good. And sooner or later, me and Cameron are going to be talking about, the Star Wars prequels in the future. But right now we're talking about Star Wars 7. I am speechless on this one. I'm very, very speechless. I should say that this movie is... it's debatable. Because I haven't seen, the entire movie of 5 and 6 yet. I've seen some clips of it, but I haven't seen the entire movie of 5 and 6. But by far, this is the best Star Wars movie I have seen, period. Until I've seen 5 and 6. Because I know Star Wars and 5 and 6 are pretty much the biggest classics in any Star Wars films. You know, more classic than the first Star Wars, A New Hope. Well, if you want to call it that. But I always call it by Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi, because the prequels are utter shit. But, oh my god, Star Wars Episode 7 was amazing. Alright, let me tell you this. I was wearing the 3D glasses for this one. I had 3D glasses on, I see it in 3D, and my god, I'll tell you what my experience was when the movie began, because... when I got close to the Tinseltown, I got even more excited, to the point where I'm actually starting to get tears built up in my eyes. It's like, I've never felt this excited before. And then I saw long ago in the galaxy far, far away, and that music blared up, oh my god, I wanted to cry a lot. But it's like, no. Don't cry just yet, man! You got the entire movie! You got the entire movie! You got 2 hours and 25 minutes to see this movie! So I went into the journey, and my god, the journey was quite fascinating, especially in 3D. I highly recommend seeing it in 3D, but it's also released on IMAX, and I didn't have the money for it. And if I had to see, this movie in IMAX or in the movie theater where I was in, it was a Cinemark theater called XD 3D, where it's extreme 3D, where it's similar to IMAX. If I had to see it in that, oh my god, I would be even more of an emotional wreck. I'll tell you that for damn sure.
Just a little notice, this was filmed the night after I watched Star Wars The Force Awakens in 3D. I had the chance to see it again, but this time in 2D, because 3D really strained my eyes out and I had a migraine. But after watching it again, now I know who the person is in the ending. And of course, this is spoiler free, so I am not going to spoil anything. You must see the movie to believe it.
Give this movie, you know, watch this movie. Absolutely see this movie in theaters, especially in 3D, if you have the money, especially in IMAX, because it is a movie that you gotta see to believe when it comes to all of this effects, this, oh, the lightsaber swords are just, oh man, they feel, oh, it gives me chills every time when I, you know, see anything that's going on when it comes to action and everything else. Yeah, it feels like, oh man, this is more raw and enthusiastic about these lightsaber fights. You know, the stormtroopers invading and the explosions. Well, at least Michael Bay. But yeah, I would highly recommend this film. Please see it in theaters, especially in 3D or IMAX if you have the money. This movie is a 5 out of 5 for me. 5 out of 5. So, yeah. That's all I have to say about Star Wars Episode 7. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time on Mayle and Mackert Reviews.
On the next Mayle and Mackert Reviews, Bo and Cameron face their biggest childhood regret of all time, Barney the Dinosaur. And if their day couldn't possibly get any worse, they review Barney's Great Adventure. Will they be able to review the movie, or will they go batshit insane? Tune in next time on Mayle and Mackert Reviews.